I'm in a very weird space. I have very mixed feelings about everything that's going on. I don't see any grand goal that I'm going to. And that's kind of okay, I guess. This is life, most of it. And I'm just trying not to concentrate on that. But it's so tricky. How do you not concentrate on something that might be your future? I don't know.
Я езжу в Москву в музыкальное училище почти что каждый день. И иногда приходится вставать даже очень рано, часов 5-5:30 утра. Дорога до Москвы занимает примерно 2 часа. Приходится много готовиться к занятиям в училище, особенно к таким сложным предметам, как гармония, аранжировка, теория музыки.
С гроздями всякими. Не так очень поется.
Сережа, начинаешь?
Я возвращаюсь в Обнинск иногда очень даже поздно, 9-10, даже в 11 вечера. Ну, иногда приходится мне так ездить в Москву 4-5 раз в неделю.
The situation in Russia, music-wise, is that you go to musical school first, you have to be there for 7 years, then you go to musical college for 4 years, and then the highest step would be the Academy of Music, where you spend from 4 to 5 years.
Так, нижние, пожалуйста, все поем. Все поем нижние, начали. Раз, до, ре. Ре, си, до, ре, соль, си, ля. А теперь только те, которые будут петь верхний голос. Кто поет верхний голос? Так, ну постарайтесь, пожалуйста. До, си, си, ля, соль, фа, дис, фа, ми, бемоль, ре. Так, хорошо. Теперь поем все септаккорды. Септаккорд первой ступени, да? Вот, значит, мотив. Да? А потом повторение его.
In the first place, banjo is a really not typical instrument in Russia. They're not familiar with the whole bluegrass world, so me by playing the academy, I sort of introduce them to that music.
Так, объявляй программу.
Первое произведение называется Natchez Trace. Natchez Trace. Вот. Композитор Bella Flag.
Bell?
Да, Bella Flag. Mm-hmm. Это она традиционная.
Традиционная.
Да. В конце будет Foggy Mountain Breakdown. Фоги, туманы, да. Тоже она традиционная.
Чего?
перепутал, потому что это я перепутал.
Да.
Я написал родственный инструмент.
Понял,
да?
Да.
А потом будет специальность.
Все. Потом будет специальность.
Все, спасибо большое.
Да, ну не уходи.
Да, я здесь, в вашем отношении.
Ну, приговор свершился.
Ну все.
I went when I've been in Russia this time, last time. I went to Moscow to see my ex-classmates, my dean of my faculty. And those people, they're just doing their thing, you know. Every day they're getting ready for a new year, for a new semester. And I just don't fit there. Sometimes looking at them, looking at all my people I knew of my age, that are studying right now. Sometimes I feel like I'm sleeping, like I'm not even, like it's not even happening in real life. Makes me feel like I'm just gonna, how do you call this? You do this, pinch? So it makes me feel like, you can say that. Makes me feel like I'm gonna pinch myself and wake up, because it's just, it's not a good thing, and it's not a bad thing. It's just, sometimes it feels like everything is just starting. Sometimes it feels like it's not real. And that's not a very pleasant feeling. That's a feeling of not belonging.
Excuse me. Well, that's my daughter's Bible. Thank you so much. I appreciate it.
It wasn't my fault.
Thank you. It fell out. Thanks.
I'm glad.
You were telling me the truth, weren't you? You were telling me the truth.
I went through a divorce 11 or so, 12 years ago, and there was two children involved, my son and daughter, Michael and Michelle, and you know how those things turn out. That was a horrible thing, and those children were out of my life for quite some time now. And it's funny, I feel myself now as a newborn father to seven teenagers. So it's changed my life drastically. I figured we'd get together and spend about two or three months together, and they'd be on their path. And here, 2 years later, it's 24/7.
I don't know. I think we all are waiting for something big and good for us. But I will not predict anything because I'm superstitious. I would say it this way. For me, the best thing is to play a big stadium with thousands of people, and they would scream, and they would love my music. They would love what I do, and I will be proud of what I do. That's what I call my dream, and that's what I call success for me.
I believe that we're gonna be big, famous. Like in Russia, nobody knows us actually, you know, because we're from a small city and we're playing country music just in a couple of bars in Moscow. So nobody actually knows us. And I wonder how that's gonna, you know, happen. Like people in Russia will realize that we're Russians and we're actually from their country.
Let's see, you guys, are girls ready? Have you been?
This is Vova's drawing.
Okay.
Happy birthday.
You're welcome. Thank you very much.
Yes. Very good.
Oops.
Masking.
One spot.
Oh, yeah. Jerry Douglas has already playing that on stage.
It's like opening the door that you were looking at for years and didn't have keys. So now we have a key and we'll see what we got inside.
The most important thing I like about America is if you work hard and you have talent and luck, a little bit of luck, in the right environment, I think you have a chance to make a good living. Where in Russia, realistically, I don't think I'll be able to make a good living just doing this kind of music.
Якобы успел пожить в то время, когда был у нас вот коммунизм. Но я это затронул, будучи еще совсем маленьким человеком. А когда произошли действительно вот эти перемены от Союза к непосредственно государству российскому, стало больше свободы. Гораздо больше свободы, много нищеты, много обмана, который продолжается по сей день. Так далее. Я думаю, что я все-таки русский человек, я хочу быть в своей стране, ну и я буду обязательно Россию дома.
Together for 10 years, and the last 4 years, I think, everybody was telling us, you know, this is gonna happen in a month, this is gonna happen in a year. So now I feel like I'm a little bit tired of waiting. I'm waiting for the day when I really start working. Because now I feel like it's still the same, like years ago, when they were saying, this is the time when it all starts, this is... And now I feel like, well, maybe this time it will. I'm gonna be rich and famous.
If there's anything that I like to do in producing and making records, it's at the front stage of something. It's finding young talent, enthusiastic. There's no barriers there. There's no fear. There's no nothing except, wow, we're making a record. But the one thing I do try and tell new artists is you gotta be able to take rejection. You gotta be able to bury your heart and your soul in some of your best work and expose a lot of yourself. And you'll have people that will applaud that, and you'll have people that won't. And that's a tough deal. Maybe at their age, maybe it may prick their hearts a little bit more, or maybe they'll be so young and full of themselves, they'll kind of roll off their back, you know.
Not in my heart, out of my
hands, not in my heart. Shelter and storm, I'm in between, so why should I have to decide them? You are the river, you are the whispering trees. Do what you ask, if only I could. But I cannot choose between.
Ну вот этот мне голос нравится, который начал. Вот самый, самый.
Давай попробуем спеть вдвоем.
I have a dear friend who my wife and I bought a farm from several years ago, and her husband was an art dealer, and they had a gallery in Scottsdale. And she called me up one day and asked me if I would take an appointment with a friend of hers. I said, sure, I'd be glad to see anyone that you want me to see. Well, it's a friend of mine. He's in the art business, but he has found this Russian country band. And my immediate reaction was, oh, no, I can't believe I'm going to do this.
As a Russian art dealer, I go to Russia a lot. On one visit, it was suggested that maybe we go to a Mexican restaurant for dinner. I went to the Mexican restaurant, and it was very quiet. And I thought, just exactly what I need because I'm very, very tired. And then all of a sudden, I noticed a band was marching up onto the stage, which meant it wasn't going to be quiet for long, and I almost left. I realized the band was very young. They ranged from 14 to 18 at that time. And all of a sudden, they started to sing in English. And they were playing American country and bluegrass music. I knew I had to do something. So I contacted one of my people in Russia and said, look the group up, arrange for visas to come here for 90 days. I'll pay all the expenses, and in that 90 days, we'll make something happen.
I took the meeting with Ray. And he told me the story about the band, and he played me a really bad demo tape with just a little bit of music on it. From that, I heard enough to be interested. I was, though, a little bit afraid of the fact that they were, at that point in time, almost a novelty. I felt at that point in time it was going to be a mistake to try to rush something out, that they needed a chance to grow, to spend some more time in America, to become a little bit more Americanized, or it was going to be a problem, them being branded just as a novelty. And I just kind of lost touch with them. I didn't have any contact with them for, I guess, almost 2 years.
Well, I had hoped in the beginning that I could just cheer them on and give them whatever help from the sidelines I could. But it's a big process. It's not a simple thing. Where you might think it takes this amount of time and this amount of money, it probably takes this amount of time and this amount of money.
Чем? Что он сгорело? Я надеюсь, вы соображаете, да, что он сначала должно прогореть, все дела.
Эй, слушай, это не учи отца и
баста. Воняет ужасно, фу.
Нет, это посмотри, пришла и начала...
И распи...
Начала говно.
Не, оторвали, отпи... Нет, нет, вам нужно просто вместе его скрести и вот так немножко поворочить, чтобы они все прогорели.
А угадьте женщине телевизор, пусть идет домой.
I'm the boss. Все, хватит столько, Шура?
Дозняк.
Можно мне следующий? А еще нужно что-нибудь пропитать.
А то мы хотели песню про пончик.
Я не помню, в чем была там фишка, но я помню, что он был про
пончик. А должна петь, должна петь?
Ты должна петь, ты должен петь голос.
А, я думал... А, окей. Мороз. Пардон.
Вернее, пластинка, пластинка. Сказка.
Просто наливать ничего.
Рябушка. Нет, про какую-то испанскую.
А что вторые ложки не забиваете?
Моего коня белогривого.
And then I went back and saw them perform again over at Mike Hinneman's dugout studio and decided that we wanted to go after them and see if we could sign them 2 years later.
Mama's pancake breakfast.
Are y'all ready?
Uh-huh.
Okay.
Pancake breakfast. Mama's pancake breakfast.
Okay.
If you have Papa's pancake breakfast.
No, just Mama's.
All right. That will work.
Okay.
I'll take cherry pancakes.
Okay. I just got to ask you, are you a country music fan? Yeah. You got on a John Michael Montgomery show.
Okay. Now we need to go over this. The good part.
Okay.
I've always been told that you're getting something headed your way and it never showed up. This is your first record advance. What we're going to do on Monday is go get your Social Security numbers.
One of the things that I think is so hard for people to grasp is how rare it is for anyone to get this kind of chance.
Thank you, Mike.
We think about the hundreds of thousands of people who are very talented and who desire to do this. It begins to put it in perspective. It's really, really a very, very small group of people that ever get the chance to do what these kids are getting to do.
Does that tempo feel good for you?
Well, I'll throw it down there.
And then let's just, for the first few minutes, you know, we'll just be getting some of the sounds in your earphones and just bear with me until we get the mix right. So let's do the same. Did you get that bass, that buzz out of the bass? Let's run it down, guys. Touching on a lot of different levels other than just the culture difference between Russia and the U.S. You know, we were diving into the music and how to take their musicianship and their individual talents and mold that into their future, so to speak. Back it up. Let me just play back that chorus and sing that harmony part.
Okay. Yeah, go ahead and sing it.
I really like where we're going right now with that music that we got so far. Cause, you know, I think the cool thing about the band, I think we sort of found our own sound, you know, sort of approach. Actually, the one who started the band was our classical guitar teacher. He was a really hardcore bluegrass fan, and somehow he got this cheap banjo and some tapes of Earl Scruggs and Bill Monroe and Lester Flatt. Yeah, and that's how it all started.
there is not a blade of bluegrass to be seen anywhere near the Russian town of Obninsk. But Ilya Tashinsky has been picking the banjo since he was 10. He is now a teenager with a passion for bluegrass.
You know, the first time I was given these finger picks, I put them on the wrong way. I tried to play something and nothing happened.
Obninsk was once closed to foreign visitors, but the isolation didn't limit 13-year-old Natasha Borzilov's interest in bluegrass. So with all this talent, music teacher Alexei formed the group Cheerful Diligence.
Говорю, что сначала это была чисто механическая работа. Я сейчас просто объясню, что такое механическая работа. Механическая работа — это когда слушаешь, играешь с точностью до ноты то, что сыграно на чьей-то записи. Это просто отрабатывалось, слушалось, снималось и доводилось до такого состояния, пока это не было уже окончательно близко к эталону, к той записи, которую мы брали. Но потом это отошло, потому что мы сами смогли, стали уметь это делать. А так все до последнего дня Алексей нас курировал.
He just made everybody practice really hard, you know. Like, for example, we went to the summer trip, like a camping trip on the Black Sea. It was meant to be like a fun trip, just go get some sun, you know, just go swim in the sea. And instead of that, we've been practicing for like 10 hours a day. Like early in the morning, he would wake us up, 8 o'clock. I'll go on the roof of the building and play my banjo for 3 hours. And then and Sergey would play violin, whoever, you know, everybody play their instruments. Then we'll get together and have a group rehearsal. And like probably 10 hours a day. Then we'll take a break and go for 30 minutes to, you know, to swim a little bit. And I'll come back and practice more. He was really, you know, he was really freaky in that way, and he was really tough.
Иди сюда, моя птица. Иди, моя птичка.
Говорят, что там первые
были.
Ну ладно, поболтала.
Я хочу.
Съездила, посмотрела.
Тост. Можно немножко подлить?
Нет, не надо, спасибо.
Тост. Разрешим ему тост?
Можно, можно.
Можно тост. Лидия, королева Греции, Крита, Мальты.
И прочее, прочее.
И прочее, прочее.
Мы чаще были вместе.
Королева Греции, будь здорова.
Лида, за тебя.
Сапковского.
За твой успех.
Валя.
За удачу, за твое хорошее настроение. Чтобы ты не разочаровалась.
Мамулечка, твое здоровье.
Депрессия.
Никогда. Мамуля, давай.
Слышишь? Никогда
Таня.
Депрессия.
А вы же знаете, такого невозможно.
Самое лучшее, что есть, что даровано нам, это жизнь.
Это вы
Лидия должна делать то, что ей нравится. Если это не разрушает ее гармонию.
Так вот подумалось как-то
однажды. Я, например, прошу ее, чтобы она попыталась учиться в Америке на юриста. И этим самым уменьшила риск отсутствия профессии.
Ребенок приходит
а ведь школу. Так, музыкант – это человек, который не имеет профессии.
Здорово.
Сегодня он музыкант, а завтра он безработный.
Твой любимый
сапог. Крабы? Ой, замечательно.
Два месяца она заочно. Пропустила, она не может
это
догнать.
Невозможно.
А потом гораздо закончит больше. Там институт очень быстро. Быстро. Без проблем. Да.
Валера,
просто. Тем не менее. Нет, если она, подожди, если она сейчас, вот если она в группе, не будет бросать группу, будет заниматься делами и будет учиться заочно, это выход. Она не теряет времени, она занимается музыкой, своим любимым делом, и учится заочно.
Ну, это как, она свободный гражданин, и сама как решит, так и будет.
Понимаете, мне надо... Она ребенок.
Она очень молодая,
она не
надо много бы решать.
А заочно? Мне надоело вот так вот учиться, как я это делаю, то есть такими разъездами, потому что это, может быть, я получу диплом. Во-первых, это сложно, это очень-очень вымотывает. Не знаю, стоит ли мне так тратить нервы, потому что...
На грани нервного срыва постоянно находится. Мне очень жалко детёнка.
Лид, сколько ты
писала?
Я буду как этот... В принципе, ей найти хорошего человека, с которым она проживет жизнь. Вот первое. Мужчина, который будет ее любить всю жизнь, это лучшее, что можно пожелать женщине.
Накушалась.
Мамочка своя сплакала.
Мамочка не выжила. Один бутерброд.
Знаю. Это там где-то в районе Аля. Да?
I always heard those stories about the bands that got a little messed up because of changes in the label, and I thought nothing would ever happen to us, because Arista is a strong label, and Tim Dubois is the man, and sure enough, it happened to us.
Okay, Sergey, everybody up? Good morning. Sasha. Get up. Guys. Come on, let's meet, okay? In the living room. Come on, guys.
Потому что где-то я слышал.
Ну, вообще просто...
Да.
There is a fight right now between Clive Davis, the head of Arista, and some guys from Germany who actually own BMG. Arista belongs to BMG. And so those guys want to close Arista. And so that's what they're doing.
It's scary because we're in the middle, not knowing what we're going to do, not knowing what Tim Dubois is going to do or anybody else. And money is very tight for the band and myself. You know, with my wife, there's 10 of us in the house, stepping over each other with one bathroom to use. The business that I used to have is totally gone because this consumes all my time. And there absolutely is no more money coming in. It's just going out. And it's just about gone.
Huh. I'm, you know, on the totally opposite side of the world and doing something that can explode every day. Of course I'm worried about it, but I'm just hoping. It's as much as I can do. And I don't like this about the music business. I don't like the absence of security. I don't like that, but this is belief. This is what I believe I have chosen, so I'll just have to live with it.
The hardest thing about it is that right now we don't do anything because of the thing with the record label. We don't play out, we don't do shows, and we really miss that. And unfortunately, we cannot get our own places to live, and we have to stay all together in one place. I mean, it's not bad because we lived together for like such a long time and we're like family, but still, you know, at some point you want to get away from your family, at least for some time.
Mike was in overload because he's got a much smaller place than I do, and he's got, you know, 6-7 kids living with him.
Morning, Ilya.
Good morning.
Want some juice? I'm gonna make some coffee.
And so, you know, I just said, you know, Mike, if you need some relief, you know, I could take, you know, one of the kids or two of the kids, you know, for a while.
That's your mama.
No, I'm spoiled. I'm
sort of a... And he said, well, you know, Brent, if you could just take just one kid, it would help us. And I said, well, sure. And he says, well, he said, you know, how about Ilya? And I said, great, you know. There's a lot of pent-up energy because these guys, they've been waiting for months and months and months, and it takes so much longer than what anybody thinks.
Итак, вернемся опять. У нас исторический момент. Наталья позирует.
I spend some time on the computer. I read books. I'm bored, and I want to do all kinds of crazy stuff. Like, for example, my wish, and I don't know if it will come true because I'm really afraid, is to skydive, you know, jump with a parachute, and I'm really afraid of heights. So, but that's, I wanna learn how to ride a motorcycle, and, you know, and I wanna do crazy things, but I cannot.
Natasha had mentioned to me about cutting her hair a few times, and she said, Michael, you know, one day I'm just gonna shave my head. I said, sure, sure you are. I said, but just let me know before you do, because I'll kill you.
Лысая девочка.
Что, хотите первое, что ли?
Нет,
зачем?
Наташа!
I cannot believe.
You tricked me.
А я подстригал.
Ты?
Да.
I love it. I think it looks so cool.
I did it maybe a little bit because everybody didn't want me to do it. And I always do things like this. I'm just a little bit of a punk.
I had to wait before I could even talk to her about it. And then I mentioned it, and we had our explosion, and a few days later, she had a wig.
Oh, I hate it.
Oh, God. I'm gonna wear this wig whenever Tim Dubois is around, because I'm just afraid that this side will upset him.
She bought a wig.
Did she?
On the bed to love a vow, on the benches that they lean, on the bed to stop it, cry and let it fail.
We had a couple of meetings, you know, in the band, and we decided that we really need another bass player who would maybe fit better with us.
Ну, это, конечно, непростая ситуация в чисто человеческих отношениях, потому что мы все очень здорово относимся и относились всегда к Андрею. Это было не просто сообщить ему.
It was a hard change for us, because we've been with Andrei for many years. We've been together in many different trips and concerts, so it was a hard decision, but we couldn't, you know, hold from it. We just had to make it.
Ой, ну, чувства такие раздвоенные, как бы. С одной стороны, я понимаю, что, ну, вот, судьба есть такое понятие, что не просто так случилось. Ну, вот, что, видимо, так и должно было. С другой стороны, мне, конечно, очень, ну, как бы жалко, с одной, я не знаю, жалко, не жалко Андрея, потому что, ну, я не знаю, у человека, видимо, ну, такая судьба. Как-то к этому так вот надо относиться, мне кажется, больше по-философски. Вот. Потом, как бы, с самого начала, когда я разговаривал с ребятами об этом, о том, что я сюда приеду, вот, ну, мы говорили о том, что Андрей не останется, то есть его не бросят, там, не выбросят за борт.
Что я могу сказать о себе? Я говорю, я не знаю пока. Я уже говорил, что я очень спокойный человек по жизни, меня очень трудно разозлить, допустим. Что-то делать я буду, по крайней мере, помирать я не
собираюсь.
I miss people that I love, my mother, my grandmother. We have a computer at home, and my mom and I write each other letters every day, like probably 3 letters a day, email. She misses me very much. I miss her very much, and I really, I miss my dad a lot. My father was one of the leading scientists in Russia, doctor of science, environmental problems. That was his specialty. And when the Chernobyl disaster happened, he was the head of the government commission that went to Chernobyl to find the ways to clean the river, to just get rid of all the radiation, which is impossible. But he was the head of this commission, and radiation was one of the causes of his early death. He died when he just turned 50. I was 13 when he died, and I was at home the day when he died. I saw everything. I was supposed to have exam, musical exam that day, so I stayed home and practiced, and I saw the whole thing that happened. I felt very angry in the very beginning when it just happened. But then I got used to the thought that he's not with us very soon. I don't know why, but in a few days I was okay. I thought that I was okay. Now I understand that it was just mind's rejection of the fact that it happened. I just told myself that my dad went on a business trip somewhere and he's gonna come back. Start to realize how big was this called impact on my life.
We had a meeting with Tim Dubois recently, and he was telling us that he loves us and he wants us to be with him no matter what. And Tim's moving to Gaylord, so we're gonna go with him. Like that.
That's cool.
You go, son.
That might be, that might be just as simple as that. Might be cool.
We have the arrangements done. Now all we need is words. Lord, go to work. Hold the pencil for you. I have, since you walked out of my dreams into my life.
Yeah, I like this idea about, have you ever seen sunrise or something? These beautiful colors. And you actually can see that if you are in love or something like that, the idea.
Right. Have you ever felt the world stop turning, turn up burning down inside?
Yeah,
have you ever done it right there?
Oh.
Stay on that.
That's gorgeous. That's sharp.
Na, 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 na.
Let me do some guitar suggestions.
I think words can describe harmonies. Words can describe are a little
loud.
Bit
too loud. I think it's good when the vocal is not like loud all the time, that you know it just goes up and down, like the dynamics, you know. But let's hear it.
Steve says he wants to go ahead and try and get the single out in November. I've got
I'm
a gut feeling
glad.
That all of a sudden it's just
going to
hit.
I want something to get going.
Yeah, me too.
I want to be busy and go and actually do something.
Yeah.
I mean, I want to be tired from working, like all the normal people are.
Hello. Everybody's fine, thank you. Well, we have a rehearsal starting about 10 to 11 at the latest. The outdoor show is at 5:30. Yeah, that's on the plaza. And then the Grand Ole Opry, we start about 8:50.
Check, hello, check, one, two. C1, check, hello, check, hello, check. Good to Tim, one, two, hello, check. Check, one, two.
Wow.
Cool, huh?
This is what I'm gonna play.
Awesome, huh?
The steel guitar will be staged left over here.
Are we gonna have like little time, like
no, to plug in and get it ready to go? You've got about 30 seconds to a minute, just depending on how you're on the show.
Because they're gonna be doing a commercial on air while we're walking out.
The Opry is one of the most unique shows probably around in the fact that there are no rehearsals, there are no sound checks. If the musicians walk out and if they've got electric guitar, they plug in and they start playing.
Right.
There's no time to check anything. It's just a run out, plug in, and play.
We'll be ready.
Yeah, man, we're professionals. We're going to nail it.
That's
and,
right.
One more question.
Okay.
How many people are in here?
What's it seats 4,424.
So I talked to the sound guy, and I'm going to be back there with him, and we're going to hit up.
Oh, Will.
We need to be by the backstage door in 10 minutes. Okay, are we tuned up and ready to go?
Yeah.
Does anybody know where Ilya is? Anybody seen Ilya?
He was here. A few minutes
ago. Where's Michael?
Where is everybody?
Who called? And who called? Dance.
Thanks, Tom.
Guys!
What's more?
Hey, guys, we shall live. We're a couple minutes away, but I wanted you in here.
Yeah. Yeah.
City store that carries work clothes, so dress for success with Dickies, a legend at work. You're listening to the Friday Night Opry on Clear Channel at 650 WSN, Nashville, Tennessee.
Now, this portion of the Friday Night Opry brought to you by Country Bob's All-Purpose Sauce. For your free sample, just log on to the internet site, countrybobs.com, and sign up for your free sample. Country Bob's All-Purpose Sauce. Now, some great entertainment from the stage of the Grand Ole Opry. This is a new group. Well, it's a new group for us anyway. Here to introduce him is Jim Ed Brown.
And I thank you very much, sir. This is a new group. You know, it's very seldom that we find a group like this that is this popular, that has never been on stage at the Grand Ole Opry. But these youngsters come all the way from Russia. And, but they do speak English, thank goodness I found that out. But they are here. Well, let me, this young lady, I think, is the spokesman for the group. Natasha? Yes?
Yes.
Natasha, why did you come to Nashville?
I'm recording here.
You're recording an album?
Yes, an album.
And then you're going back home?
I'll be going back and forth.
Back and forth.
I think we're going to stay here. Feel like it in here.
You know what? I'm going to get out of the way. Ladies and gentlemen, please say hello to all of these youngsters. They're known as Bering, Strait.
My God, that's a smash. That's a you know.
Cool.
That's a good day's work.
I guess so.
Hey, it's 10:31 at WLX. Eddie Landtrup along with Dan Hollander this morning. Dan, we've got something really special coming up.
We do. Folks are down here to give us a preview of some upcoming talent in country music.
Now, here's what we want. All the folks that are... have an access to the telephone, if they would give us a call here at the station, you know, listen to this song and tell us what you think.
Just like on American Bandstand. Rate a record. Here we go.
Mm-hmm.
I don't think music by a Russian artist or group would go in the United States. It's not so much their vocals, nor the music, nor the lyrics, but the fact how they would be accepted being from Russia.
This is WMLX. How are you this morning?
I'm fine, how are you?
Doing good.
I didn't like it.
Didn't like it?
No, I thought it sounded like the Forrester Sisters. I don't like them.
Oh, you didn't like the Forrester Sisters?
No.
Is it anything that you think would come from Russia?
No, they sound like Yankees.
Oh, they sounded like Yankees? Good morning, WMLX. How are you this morning?
I'm fine. Eddie, they need to slow down. You can't understand anything they're saying.
You say they're too fast?
Right.
WMLX, how are you?
Okay.
And what did you think about the song?
I like them. I think they have potential.
Really?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Those kids are from Russia. That doesn't bother you at all?
No, they don't sound like they're from Russia.
Yeah. Hey, thanks for calling.
Okay.
Bye-bye. Bye. We're going to play another song by this group and give us a response. 762-6200. See what you think about this song.
I could be persuaded to give my heart to you. If you promise not to break.
I like it. That's good music. That's real good music. She don't sound like no Russian or anything like that. Sounds like an American that's got her heart into her music.
How are you?
She sounded like she was Southern.
Is she Russian? No, I wouldn't have had any idea.
I watch a lot where they've got it hard there, too. Life's the same everywhere. It's just a different place.
I believe this country's country. And it is country. Because I'm country.
Say, Natasha
Borzalova.
Yeah.
That's enough.
Do what? Natasha
Borzalova.
Say what now?
Ilya Toshinsky.
Ilya Toshinsky.
I can't say that. Try again.
Ilya Toshinsky.
Ilya Toshinsky.
Ilya Toshinsky.
I ain't saying that.
What?
Ilya
Notisha.
Well, now they're going to have to change them names.
Natasha Borshinova.
Ilya
Toshinsky. Ilya Toshinsky. You're going to love it.
Could be a problem.
Bering Strait is, isn't that up around Norway, up in that area? I do a lot of crosswalks.
It's in the ocean, right?
My old lady just told me that it's in between Russia and where? Tell me again.
Six pox old boats out.
And she said that was called the Bering Strait. But I never heard of it until she just told me.
I was laying in my bed and thinking, okay, I think I got to the point where I really can think positive because I see it's coming up, you know. And so I was kind of laying in bed, okay. And I was imagining these photo shoots, video shoots, you know, interviews, media training, and buzz, you know, around town that this band is finally, you know, putting an album out. And, you know, I was so excited, and I just couldn't wait till this fall finally comes. And when it came, well, we had this news from Gaylord.
Gaylord was building a label one day, and the next day they were tearing it down.
We don't have a label again. And I thought that this thing was over with long time ago, and obviously it's not. And it's just, and one more time, it shows me that this business is very far from stable, and you can just wake up one more, hey, I don't have a record deal anymore, and it's just upsetting.
It put us back where we were half year ago, year ago, 2 years ago. It's like we're floating, like, and reaching some certain points, but we still cannot move upper, you know?
Папочка, здравствуй. Ты не спишь? Это хорошо. Папочка, я вот только проснулась и прочитала твое письмо.
My father actually is not that optimistic about my music. He doesn't. Sometimes I'm talking to him and telling him, well, do you think I'm just doing nothing here? Do you understand this is what's happening? Do you understand how many people are engaged in the whole picture? He's just afraid that if I'm just going to be dropped out of the picture suddenly, of this music, I'm going to be nobody.
Вообще, я просто это ты в сердце как я себя чувствовала, когда я нажала ему.
I'm missing more the connection with people. My family and friends, my city, the feeling I get when I go out on the street, you know, and walk. Because here, it's if you get depressed, you get really depressed. Because there's nothing you can do. Because you don't want to drive to town, it's like 35 miles. And here there's three horses and a donkey. You know, that's all the outside company you can get.
I'm sure that they've had anxious moments of like saying, God, what is going on? I mean, is our record ever going to, I mean, are we ever going to land someplace and stay? I imagine they felt that. But I think they have a lot of faith in the inner circle. I think they have a lot of faith in Mike, myself, and Tim, that somehow we're not going to let this ball get dropped.
Okay, guys, let's do this thing and knock on Mr. Tim Dubois's door.
Hey, come in.
Hello.
Come in.
Tim.
Hey.
Good to see you.
Hey, Tim. How are you?
Come on in. Well, I'm glad to have you all over today. We haven't really had a chance to sit down, all of us, in a long time. And I want to bring you up to date on what I've done since leaving Gaylord and basically just try to answer any questions that you all have as to where we are in the process, because I think we are standing at some forks in the road in regard to some things.
Yeah, I have just last question is about if people ask us right now, like, what's going on with you, will be like the proper answer, you know, not...
We're trying to get out, you know, I think the proper answer is we're still caught up in the Gaylord mess. You can call it the Tim Dubois mess for all I care. This time in the country music business is the worst that I have ever seen it. I've been here 23 years, and, you know, it's tough right now. And instead of growing and there being more companies and more acts signed and more records out, more records doing well, everything's getting smaller.
You know, it's just a little kind of scary. Last year we played those showcases like six in 2 days or five mm-hmm. in 2 days, and we had over 3-4
it
offers.
It was more than 2 years ago, actually.
Yeah. Sorry.
Yeah.
And we had those offers. People wanted to work with us. Now we've done the album, and looks like people are passing on us. You know.
Well, remember, nobody said, no, you guys stink, go home, okay? Mm-hmm. Everybody's still interested in it. You know, there's people that are in this business that we haven't even let them know that we're available at this point. Are they
going to close? Tim has different kind of problems, and the kinds of problems we're dealing with is this is money, this is trying to make a decision at this exact time, at this exact moment. He doesn't have to do that. He's looking at the picture to a bigger perspective, and I don't see it this way. I see it as a problem that is just right in my face, and I don't know what to do about it. I mean, I cannot be philosophical when it's my life we're talking about, you know? Sometimes I just wanted something to happen right now.
Obviously, we have a time problem, and since we have already spent 3 years working on this mm-hmm. record, so what's your view on this timing problem?
Well, I think the sooner the better, obviously. But at the same point in time, I think you got a couple months before your looks go away.
It's not about the look. No, it's about the way that we live here. Well, I mean, we want to do something, obviously.
It's a matter of survival. Actually.
Yes,
people
sure.
ask this question about, when is your album going
to
be released?
You have to live here somehow, and you have to... And the salary that we make is...
Yeah.
That's the most stressful part of this whole deal is there's... a lot of us are really suffering. I mean, down to the penny, man.
Yeah.
I mean, and sweating bullets. And these guys, I mean, to be living on what they're on, it's below the mm-hmm. poverty level.
Mm-hmm. It's just hard.
And right now, as I understand it, you guys, because of the way your visas are, you can't... Do
we cannot
anything.
Work in Burger King. We can't.
Yeah. Just music-related industry. Yeah.
Well, there are those situations where you would be better off to wait a few months than to do a bad deal. And I think I've told you all before at some point in time, there's a lot of truth to the old saying that no deal is better than a bad deal. You're better to not...
Just sometimes you get tired and you say, well, where is it? As if Michael said, I really like what he said. If somebody comes in the door with something, with a paper in his head that at least looks like a recording contract, we're gonna sign it. So that's my position. Tim said that it's better to have no record deal than a bad record deal. Well, I think it's better to have something. Because something will mean that we're doing, that we're growing, that we are making progress. Time for him and time for me are a lot more different.
How long and what crazy turns this whole thing has taken.
I have a question. It's a sensitive issue. I mean, we all love Brent Mayer to mm-hmm. death, and he's a part of our family mm-hmm. now, and he's a great producer, and mm-hmm. you know, we all love the album. But mm-hmm. what if we have to cut another album? Is he still going to be the producer, or is it going to be somebody else?
Well, I think the reality is that you might face that pressure. Somebody might say, you know, I want to cut four more sides and I want to do it with someone else. Or they might say, I want to do an entire new album and I want to do it with somebody else. And then it's going to be up to you guys. You have to sit down, and that's a hard place to be because Brent has invested his heart and soul in this thing, you know. It would not be an easy thing to do.
If we have to revisit the whole album and do it without Brent Mayer, God, well, that'll be really hard to do. To be honest, really, really hard.
I would hate you, but I can't. I wish I could leave you, but I stay. I say I could walk 1,000 miles just to get away, coming back again.
just wish that we would be doing what we came here to do, so we feel like a family again. But I prepared myself to the thought that this band is gonna break up, and I am prepared for being left literally alone, facing all the problems of starting over and trying to get my own career started, if it's possible.
I say I could walk 1,000 miles just to get away, coming back again.
As a band, that's probably, you know, the worst time we ever had. It's like the lowest point. We had a conversation, what you gonna do, you know, if it all falls apart? Who's going back to Russia? Who's gonna stay, you know? How are we gonna go on as a band? Because it's really tough, you know, we're in another country, we don't have a support from our families. You know, I'm frustrated too. I'm tired of going back home and tell my mom that, you know, we're so close, and, you know, and it's already like three times in a row I go home and I tell them, you know, we're working this record, and here we need 4 more songs, and next time I go home, we need 1 more song, you know, and I want to go home next time and tell my mom, you know, that I achieved something, you know.
It can't get any worse, means I'm gonna be okay. And you won't read any word of the story, looking at my face.
We're gonna lose so much more if we give it up just because we cannot take it anymore. So, I cannot speak for everybody. I'm frustrated. I'm scared. I just can't afford saying, okay, I quit, that's it. I'm going home, I'm studying. I know that I just can't afford to do that. And so that's why it's not even a question. I know that too many people have sacrificed a lot more than I probably will ever to try to make this thing happen. I know I'm gonna screw up a lot of people if I do that. So it's not even a question anymore. Too many people involved.
I'm scared to death. Yeah. You know, we may lose everything. I lost the studio a couple of weeks ago. And we're probably a month away from losing our home. And so there, like I said, I spend a lot of time on the knees. I spend a lot of time at a church here called the Upper Room, and just, you know, you have to. I spend a lot of time with God, hoping that this will work out.
You know, he wouldn't have given us up then, and he probably wouldn't do it now too. Because we are, in a way, his hope. And it's a very big burden. I don't want to think about that. I don't want to feel like I'm somebody else. I don't want to feel like I'm somebody else's last hope. It's horrible. It's a horrible burden. But it happened like that. What can I do? There's not much I can do about it.
That's why I'm here when he's gone.
I try to live today's day, not tomorrow. Because I just realized that whenever you think that it's like you hit the bottom and it's like the worst day of your life, then something happens and you get a phone call that says that your apartment is burning down.
Live from the News 2 Mobile City Cam, you can see a massive fire in South Nashville is still burning at this hour. Good evening, everyone. We begin tonight with developing news in South Nashville, where a huge apartment fire has been burning for about an hour and a half, and it could be seen for miles.
As flames ripped through the apartment building, Sergei Passoff and his roommates could only watch as their first home in America was destroyed.
We lived in the host families before all the time, and it was like our first real apartment. And it's kind of sad, you know, to watch it go down so fast.
This is one of those classic Nashville stories. Sergei and his roommates moved here to be musicians, like so many other people. The black smoke starts billowing into their apartment. The first thing they do, they ran and they grabbed their instruments.
We got really scared when we like saw the black smoke coming from under and over the door, you know, and yeah, we started running around the place and we got all our instruments and we managed to save those, but we jumped from the balcony actually.
Года, наверное, два уже, почти два, когда как бы вот этот зависон непонятный, mm-hmm. что происходит.
Да, концерт на самом деле классно. Играть надо было давно. Уже года, давно, года давно два могли играть уже вообще.
Ну, да.
И жить припеваючи, все бы у нас было. А то сидим тут, чем квартира сгорела,
нужно продолжать. Нормально помогать.
Ну просто уже ждать.
Да. Ну уже да.
Ну, да
даже это в какое-то привычное состояние даже немножко важно.
Да, даже бесит уже периодически уже просто. Что такое?
Да, ну уже 4 года ждем, конечно. Да,
мозги уже так опухают.
Да. Когда позавчерашний день даже перевернул нашу жизнь, мы все переживаем, мы устаем. Все это начинается, вот это куда-то вот такая, как вниз все это катится, что-то. В конце концов, это приходит к тому, что мы уезжаем в Россию.
Там просто слишком много народу, знаешь, которого хочется видеть. Там друзья. Вот.
Да.
Все-таки там многим жертвуешь, как бы приезжая сюда, и все-таки хочется, чтобы эти жертвы не были напрасными.
Своим душевным состоянием.
Это да.
Да, это точно. То есть эта душа тянется на родину.
Просто.
Конечно.
Так что слов хороших нету.
Да.
На этот счет.
У меня все хорошо с головой.
Нет, Шура.
У меня с головой.
Нет,
Шура. Nice to meet you too. Наташа? Илья? Сергей? Александр? Сергей? Two Сергей. Why don't you sit right?
Ну, только моя еще,
кажется. Я с этим
с
Бэнс, I have my Russian signature on that. Because I had on all the other record deals that we signed, use American letters.
Yeah.
No Russian
letters.
Yeah.
I signed him at Aristotle. Then I signed him again at Gaylord.
So now they're relaxed.
I think it's four times the job on this one.
Four times the job.
The court, that's your signature.
All right. Yeah. The deed is done.
Yay!
And the journey begins.
One day.
Do you want to undo the record?
Please, no. No, please don't go away.
Pleasure to meet you.
Mrs. Hannah Sabre. Hannah, Sarah, and I'll work for you.
I know you're really thrilled.
пьесу уже написал даже так в 75-м году.
Да.
В таком духе.
Да, конечно.
А до первого никто, по-моему, еще не написал.
Смотри, пример такого клипа сейчас показывали. Там мужчина в маечке.
I think we just used to take things for granted. We were everybody's favorites since we were like 12 years old. And then we grew up and started going to America, and we had all these record deals signed. Seems like it was just all taken care of.
Yeah, I want you to do it yourself. I'm amazed.
Well, obviously, somebody didn't want us to take things for granted, and we've been put through all these troubles with labels and... So, I guess it's history, and... just checks our survival skills, you know, and hopefully we'll be together for a long time.
Вообще сам опыт – это уже огромное получение. Пока что, уже, в общем-то, прожив и проиграв на инструменте 19 лет из моей жизни, это уже огромный опыт, огромная жизнь музыканта. Но что говорить о том, каким бы я себя хотел видеть, это, наверное, немножко сложно.
I want to respect myself for what I do. I just want to hear what I play, for instance, or what I sing and say. God, if that was not me, it probably would be my favorite band, my favorite singer. And if I really do good music and I feel like I belong here, it's a feeling that cannot be compared to almost anything. You know, I just want to be proud of myself.
А что с Джеком?
Welcome to it, guys. I'll see you after. All right, have some fun.
I go.
I think, you know, I became a lot more realistic. I meet a lot of people that are kind of frustrated with the music business. But I'm trying really hard to remember that first feeling when I came to Nashville, you know, that fresh feeling, exciting feeling that, yeah, I'm here, you know, let's make it happen. The more I learn about real life in America, I learn about how to survive in America, you know?
So just do what you do. I love you. We're here, so let's do business.
Rock and roll.
Business? Oh. Come on. Let's have fun. Okay. Let's do business let's having do fun. Ball.
Show me the money.
I am so scared.
T minus 2 minutes. And ticking.
Please don't tick. The values in my life are changing. And just understanding of my place in life and what's really important to me right now, it's changing.
These guys are great. I want you to give them a big, warm United States welcome. It is their first performance ever here in the USA. Would you please make them feel welcome? MCA recording artist, Bering, Strait.
If I don't become famous, it wouldn't be a big problem. And it used to be important to me. And now it's getting less and less important. Life is a chain of disappointments. And as soon as you get something, you start wanting something else. So I'm just trying to prove to myself that I'm able to do something, capable of becoming somebody, person, a grown up. I don't think that it's too much to ask.
Hold me like a lover. Hold me like a child. Hold me like a lover.
so very much for your warm welcome. This is incredible.
Ой, ти борошка параня, ти за що любиш Івана?
Ой, я за то люблю Івана, що головушка кудрява, що головушка кудрява, а бородушка не кучерява, кудрі в'ються улиця, люблю Ваню молодца. Ой, кудрі в'ються улиця, люблю Ваню молодца. Ой, дуже канюшка погорюся, покажи моє.
Thank you very much.